43
is a good year.
Oh my God, I wouldn't want to be here.
Number one and car number one is Ed Sherkin. In the two, Joseph Bell. In the 26, Corbin Fox. In the 43, Brady O'Connor. In the 50, Matt Reum. In the 25 is Craig Ouellette. In the 30, Bob Carter. 24. Kevin Parker in the 23. The 64 of Ken Backus. 36 of Brian Blake. Ethan Gevry in the 10. Kip Shaw up there as well. I think that's the 87. Working off a tough list here. Gabriel Madison in the 38. Dustin Tierney in the 52. In the 54. I got the 168. I got to look up his number, but that's all our drivers out here. Addison County Fair, Field Days fans, for the first time tonight, I need to hear it for real. Are you ready? Once again, fans, help me count them down for the first time here, Woodpecker Demolition Derby. Five to the word, go for the Woodpecker Handshake. From five, four, three, two, one, here we go! Once again, easy touch made now. Once that right contact is made, and now it is on. Drivers will push the pedals down. Action, pick it up on all sides of the track. Thank you. stopwatches. That's what the sticks are for.
Yeah.
Drivers were all checked on their way in for helmets, seat belts. Officials have got their hands in the air almost all the way around. They've checked all the drivers, and we've got thumbs up all the way around. All right, for the second time here tonight, fans, Addison, I want to know, are you ready?
Yeah.
A little bit of room to run. name and number, Eileen. I couldn't read it off the car.
Thank you.
right, hold up. We got issues. Also, while it's quiet, we got a driver who lost a helmet out there. Drivers that are spectating on the pit side, we need you to move closer to the fence, please, so you're not blocking the equipment and stuff when they're trying to come through. Please be aware of the equipment, especially when we're clearing the track. We need you to come closer to the fence, please. Jim is back safe. Butch says we're good. Short countdown now, fans, help us. From 3, 2, 1, here we go.
Thank you.
good job by the safety personnel keeping everybody safe. That driver was trying to get out of there quickly, so we wanted to make sure that the key is turned off and there's no fuel pump trying to pump fuel there as well. Now that the extinguisher that's made for fuel, you see it goes out immediately. And that's why we have fire crew here. They use the right stuff at the right time. One, back to green. I see six, possibly seven, maybe even eight cars still going. 62 Cameron trying to make it move. It wiggled, but it didn't want to go. Looking for some help from, I think it's Scott Brace. Cam found a gear somehow, made it move. Lost his momentum. Now he's going again. Crash Cram. Good shot there on the 78 of Zeno. Hold up, guys. Hold up. Fire crew back on it again. Got some fire under the hood of the 79. Scott Grace in the 79. Gets himself out of there, running for the hills. Scott doing a good job of avoiding the driver's door on the 17, puts the shot on the rear wheel. Now work on the front wheel. Good clean shot there, avoided the door. Again, that wagon just bending further and further down, especially on the driver's side for the 79. Now he's coming in with the nose. Good shot there, but those Tauruses, they have fiberglass core supports in the front. They're not so strong. The bumpers are okay, but the core support that holds the hood, not so great. And now taking a hard shot for the 74. 74 working on that drive wheel, trying to break an axle. And now it's Jeffrey. Jeffrey that is on the clock and possibly not running as well as Brace in the 79. I'll tell you what, 17, he already won once in the four-cylinder event. Gary Grandy looking to make it a twofer right here. As it, hold up. Done. That leaves Jeffrey in the 74 and Gary in the 17. Qualifying, moving on. Two qualifiers will be here again tomorrow night, hopefully with some fresh cars for the championship event. Not a bad run. We still have one more run of six cylinders. And once again, those of you drivers that are spectating in the pits, please stay closer to six cylinder round number two. First car on the track is the 35 of Brian Blake. time. You can barely touch him. We got Benjamin and George Foster on one end, Mark Jones and Brian Blake on the other, and Chris Guyette in the middle. Passenger side. out there as well. Hog Wild Easton Gerby out there. From Lincoln, Maddie Martell. Again, Maddie, my pick to win. Let's see, from Salisbury in the 143, Gary English. From Middlebury in the 43, Dakota Miller. Still that are coming out. 164 working out of that side as well. Had some issues over near the 66 machine. All right, everybody back clear. Drivers have gotten out, looking all the way around. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Light. Able to make it go in reverse. going now. Addison Fair All-Star gear and given in the 106. Digs right in there in the 143. Two on one side, two on the other. Down there and worked on him. Then he drove all the way to Middlebury, put it in reverse. Now he's going to go all the way there and slow down, I bet. No, he makes a little glancing blow. Put himself in a bad position. a name for the X420. I should know who he is from Vermont, but I don't have it. Vermont one, I mean. Kyle Foster in the X420, and I'll need to get the 18X as well. Joey Gould in the 18, and Carl Foster in the 18X of Joey Gould. Officials are in position. Fire crew is ready. Flag is in hand. You know the drill by now, fans. Help me count down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Getting pounded in good now. trying to shift it. Saying a prayer. he's down to about 15 seconds at this point. He's trying to make it go. Alright, I mean, it's moving. Christie's moving. He's fair game. You can make a shot. That's going to do it right there. Chris Bath takes the win. Chris, thank you so much for being here with us tonight. Make sure you come and see us again.